everyone, this is Swiss Maverick. In this tutorial we're gonna look at the first 8 content of the Ace mod. A hell lot of stuff. I'm trying to make it as short and clear as possible, but yeah, there's a lot of content that I want to explain. First of all, there are like 5 different physical conditions that you can be in. That goes from exhaustion, over pain, to bleeding, to unconsciousness, and obviously to death. I'm gonna explain each and every one of them, starting with like the one that is the most harmless, which would be exhaustion. I told you that in the backpack gear item tutorial, it's important that you check on your weight, the weight of your equipment, because if you're carrying too much, your character is gonna get exhausted, and yeah, you won't be able to run anymore. So I packed a lot of stuff right now, weight 59 kilos, that's a hell lot of weight. And if I'm sprinting around now, it's probably just gonna take a couple of seconds until the exhaustion is gonna start. It's indicated yeah, alright, it's indicated by this like blacking out of the screen, and also in the background you hear my heart like beating like crazy, and you also hear like the character breathing very loud. So this means that I'm exhausted, and what happens is I'm gonna go prone. I can't walk anymore, can't run anymore. I just have to wait until that is over. So that's for the exhaustion if you're carrying too much weight, or yeah, sprinting for too long or whatever. The next physical condition that we're gonna look at is pain, and I'm also just gonna integrate the bleeding thing. For that to if you're in pain or bleeding, you need some sort of medication. You can find that here in like a first aid ammo box, or also in some other ammo box. And I'm here in a medic character, so you see I have a medic backpack on. If I open that, I get some medic equipment in there. And I also have here on my personal slots, I have some medic equipment. Just gonna explain you what it is and what you use it for. First thing here is a bandage that is used to stop bleeding. So if you're injured and bleeding, you use a bandage to stop it. And the compress, same effect, although the compress like has like the double effect, you know. So if you're just bleeding a little, you use a bandage, and if you're bleeding a lot, you use a compress. Yeah, for stop the bleeding faster or more efficient. And then you got morphine. Morphine is a painkiller, so if you're in pain, you use morphine to stop your pain. And epinephrine, or short EP, that's what you use if you're unconscious. So basically if another guy is unconscious and you want to wake him up. And then there's also a medikit to heal completely, but that's usually just used by medic soldiers. So what we're gonna need is a bandage, and we're gonna need morphine. First I need to be injured. I'm just gonna drop a grenade to injure myself. I think I'm not injured yet. Nope. Now I'm alright, I'm injured now. You see the edge of my screen is like pulsing red, and if it's pulsing red, it means that I'm bleeding. That is the bleeding indicator. So I need to apply a bandage or a compress real soon before I bleed out. If I wait too long, I'm gonna bleed out, I'm gonna fall unconscious, and if no one is coming to help me, I'm gonna die sooner or later. To help myself, I use the self-interaction menu, and then I get 3 runes. And if I have one of the, or if I have medic equipment on me, medic items, I can use them. Stop bleeding. I'm gonna do that. So now I'm applying a bandage or a compress to myself. And as you see, the red edges of my screen that stopped. I use the same menu again. Stop bleeding is not available anymore. So this means that I have stopped the bleeding. If I'm heavily bleeding, it's possible that this option is still available. So I just put on another bandage or a compress that is more effective against bleeding. So bleeding is stopped. That's always the first priority. The first thing you need to do is stop bleeding, because otherwise you're gonna fall unconscious. And now I'm still in pain. Pain is indicated by white blinking edges of my screen. Maybe I don't see it now, or just in pain a little bit. And this has an effect. If I'm also in too much pain and don't do anything about it, I can also fall unconscious because of the pain. And it's definitely going to affect my aiming and stuff like that. So we always use morphine after you have been... After you have stopped the bleeding. I'm gonna use morphine. Nice shot of morphine. Alright, done. I'm gonna recheck with the self interaction menu. I have all this stuff is not available anymore, and now here I have the first aid. So that's the medic kit, and that's what I need to heal myself completely. And usually, depending on how the mission is set, what ace modules you use in the editor, the only medics can use first aid. And since I'm a medic, I can do that. Alright, use a medic kit, and on the top right corner, successfully patch them up. This means I'm completely healed now, no pain, no bleeding, and no side effects on aiming or whatever. So I'm fully combat ready again. So much for bleeding and pain. The next physical condition is unconsciousness. I can't really demonstrate that on myself, so I'm just gonna shoot at this poor soldier in front of me until he's passing out. Alright, he's down. I hope I didn't kill him. To apply first aid to a fallen comrade, I go up to him and then I use the ace interaction menu while looking at him. And you see now different options. Examine, drag, gear, view, map, not important. I go to examine and I get information about his injuries. He's unconscious and needs EP. He's bleeding heavily and needs to get bandaged. And he has pain and needs morphine, so he's pretty messed up right now. And now here I got the options about the things I can use. I'm gonna go for the compress because it's more effective against bleeding. Should stop the bleeding faster. I do the same again, ace interaction key while looking at him. He's still bleeding, so I stop the bleeding with another bandage or something. Same again, he's still bleeding. Alright, I stopped the bleeding now, but he's still unconscious, so I need to wake him up. So I use epinephrine, which is like adrenaline, an adrenaline shot, maybe straight through the heart or something. I'm not quite sure how it is applied in real life. So I gave him that. You see on the top right corner the message changes with every step I take. So he's unconscious, needs pain, needs EP. He's not bleeding anymore, but he has still pain and needs morphine. So I gave him one shot, he's still asleep. Go to examine again. I'm gonna give him another shot of EP. This guy is really messed up. And this needs to go fast, because if he's injured too bad, he's gonna bleed out. I'm gonna use morphine, maybe that helps. Alright, I can't use the EP anymore, so he actually should wake up any second and turn around. Yeah, there you go. Okay, he's up again. Message on the top right, he's conscious, he's not bleeding, has no pain. So he's pretty much healed, although he still needs a first aid medikit to be completely healed of his injuries. You see now he has blood on his clothes, and as soon as the heel on the top left corner, the heel bar is completed, the blood should disappear, and that indicates that he's completely healed. This takes a while, but after that he's fixed up. There you go, you see the blood stains disappeared, so now he's good to go. Alright, so that's for the unconsciousness, and how you use the medic items on a fallen comrade. If you want to use it on yourself, you use the self interaction menu, and if you want to use it on another guy, you use the interaction menu. To use to help him. That's it for the first part of this first aid tutorial. You've seen the different first aid items, what they're used for, and how you can apply them. You've seen the different physical conditions that you can be in, and how to get out of it. In the second part, we're gonna look at some more equipment. We're gonna look at a stretcher. We're gonna look at how to drag or carry a character, and how to put them in a vehicle. How to use a body bag in case a camera gets shot. Some other details. But the most important things about how to use different items you've just seen now. But if you're interested, make sure to check out part 2.